Guys, it's Simpsong321 here, back with another video, sort of more of a review than a video. And I brought to you by the Alienware m11x. This is the first version, but it still kicks a lot of ass. Some of the main stuff I've been testing it out with is, say, Grand Theft Auto 4, Gary's Mod, which isn't crazy, but it still has some load. LA Noir was a bit tipsy to play. Minecraft was decent. Liberty City Stories was decent, same thing as GTA 4, so I can't say too much. But other than that, it was pretty good. I'm not sure how much you can see here, but this version of, well, first of all, some of the first things that come with this laptop, it comes with 4 gigabytes of DDR3 memory, and this version comes with about, I think it was a 320 gigabyte hard drive. I believe something similar to that matter. I did put an SSD in here. It didn't make too much of a difference. Just some of the stuff loaded a bit faster, you know, but not crazy. So for that matter, for those who care, this thing is clocked at 1.3 gigahertz. It is a dual core, a bit slow, but it is pretty decent for what it can handle. Some of the interesting stuff that this has is it can switch to from dual graphics cards. So all you gotta do is press the function and F6 button, or binary graphics, and it should soon change to the Intel graphics, okay? And look how fast that changed. It just changed from the NVIDIA 335M graphics to Intel graphics. The Intel graphics comes with, I believe, somewhere around almost 1 gig, if I'm not mistaken. Oops. Yeah, it comes with dedicated 64 megs of RAM, which is nothing to, you know, even just, yeah. But total memory comes about a 1.5 gigs. This is with the Intel graphics. If you're watching like even a high definition, like 1080p on YouTube, it kind of stutters, but 720p, not a problem for this thing. You get about six. Sometimes you can squeeze almost 7 hours of battery life on the Intel. On the NVIDIA graphics, I squeezed about, playing Grand Theft Auto 4, 3 to 4 hours. Which on the road, I think is pretty decent for a laptop at this size. This comes with, I believe this is an 11-inch screen. And also, the problem with this screen is that it is a little bit blurry when it glares. Not blurry. It gets like a little bit of a glare from, say, the sun or other lights. But other than that, the cool thing is you can see, if you're in a class, you can see the classmate that's staring you from behind. So that's pretty cool. It's not really, but some of the cool features are, all as you can see, the customizable lights. Like, see the Alienware logo, the power button logo, like the lights around it. All of these lights are all fully customizable to anything you want. So say, if here I open up Skype, I have customized Skype and Steam to have their own have their own color. So say if we sign into Skype, okay, well, Steam is just being really slow at the moment. But here, as you can see there, I moved the camera there for a sec. Cameraman can still focus. As you can see, all of the lights change. So say, oh, now we got to update Skype. Okay, I haven't opened it up for a while, but here, as you can see, it changes to the regular. I go out to Skype, changes to blue. At least it should. Oh, so finally Skype. Well, as you can see, blue, and then like a reddish, and then it's just cool like that. So, what does this all mean? Well, let's show you some actual gameplay of, say, Grand Theft Auto 4. So, we'll be back and we'll be showing you some gameplay of Grand Theft Auto 4 on this thing. Stay tuned.
No, because on the video, you're gonna see the entire GTA screen, so let's just fail.
We'll be right back.
Alright, so we got finally GTA loaded up in this hizzy. And we're just gonna go probably just drive around and all that other good stuff. Alright, come on. Come on, Nico. I don't know, in the video it looks might seem a little bit laggy. Alright, so we got ghetto radio over here. But I don't know how much you can see in the video. I'm getting probably about 20-ish something FPS. So, yeah, GTA plays pretty darn decent. Like, I wouldn't... I've played on GTA on this laptop for quite some time, and it plays really well.
Sideways.
Damn it, not good enough. Anyway, you get the point. It plays really well. GTA. Sorry, brother. Gotta use car. Yeah, I got a few mods on this thing. Like, it's pretty decent. Fail. Of GTA, now let's go take a look at Minecraft, shall we? Oh, wait. And also, these are the system specs. I am running it. I am running it a bit clocked down. So, if you can get, yeah, here we go. These are the specs, if you can kind of see what they are. It's getting bottlenecked by that dang CPU. It's just so slow. The graphics card is powerful, but the CPU is not. It's just getting over. So, let's go check out Minecraft now, shall we? Alright, so while we're waiting for this thing to load, okay, 1.4.7, and city. Okay. Alright, so, yeah, here is Red Game with a bunch of redstone stuff, computers and all that other good stuff. Alright, so we have the monitor running at 1080p right now, so actually let's just, where's the F11 button? There we go. Full screen that for real. At 1080p. And I don't know if you can see, it's playing pretty decent Minecraft. Alright, so let's just go, we're just gonna hang cam this. Alright, so if I can get the cameraman to look over here, we got the camera and camera LED with a microphone over here, which you probably can't see, but it is a white LED, which is pretty bright. Then down here, we got your Alienware logo with the power / sleep button or hibernate, whatever you choose to do it. You can customize all of these colors over here, and it's also hard drive indicator. So let's just go to computer, and as you can see, I'm just gonna go access here, and let's just access the hard drive. And as you can see, yeah, there we go. I'll customize it with that light. Then we got our indicator right here for Wi-Fi and caps lock right here. Yep, we're good. And then we got our full keyboard here, which is not modified. Like, we got our full backspace, full shifts, no key switched or anything like that. We even have a few media keys up here, like mute, playback, and all that. Brightness and switch to display. And then we got our trackpad here, which is a bit bumpy. I'm not sure if you can see that too well. Here, actually, let's try turning on. Yeah, there we go. As you can see, it is a textured trackpad here, so it's really nice. So we can shut the light off now. And our two buttons here, obviously. And then over here we have our, well, they're called speaker lights, but yeah, this is pretty much what they are, just two lights that are also customizable, okay? And if we turn to the back here, we can go take a look, and as you can see, if I actually turn off the brightness, because I'm at the lowest at the moment, if you turn off the brightness, you can actually see that the Alienware head actually illuminates from the screen backlight. So as well, as you can see, it has a nice, like, cutout backplate here, sort of, I guess you could call it, sort of. And, yeah, just overall, this looks so nice. Just beast. So, as you can see, here's how it looks closed. All right, there. We got the camera to focus now more. Okay, so we got our Keslington lock. We got our VGA. And then over here, we have USB. We have, I believe this is gigabit Ethernet. I could be wrong. Correct me on that if I am. Then over here, we have our HDMI. And then we have DisplayPort. Right here we have combination, I believe, yeah, MCC, an SD card reader. We got a FireWire port, which, I mean, who uses FireWire these days? Like, come on. Really? Why do you even have to integrate it? Then over here we have two more USB ports for a total of three. We have a microphone / rear out. So this audio card does do
a total of 5.1 audio out. So we have two headphone jacks. So say if you're on a plane or something like that, you instead of plugging in a wire adapter, you can just straight plug in two headphones. So you don't have to disturb anyone, or you can watch with a friend a movie. So that is just awesome. All right, so here's a really cool program that allows the lights of the Alienware to change and kind of dance to the music. Like say, the Alienware logo, the keyboard, and the two lights. And you can even modify the settings. I've done it to do the lights individually, but for now, I'm just demonstration. I'll do it for both. So say if we play a song, as you can see, cameraman, can we see it through the camera that it is moving and grooving to the lights? And just for extra effect, let's kill the lights for a second, although it is visible without the lights being cut. All right, so as you can see, there we go. You can see the Alienware logo. The keyboard is all dancing to the music, kind of, you know? Yeah, moving and grooving, and just, yeah, it's all so cool and pimp. And just kind of get a wider angle of that so you can see all the lights. All right, so I'll actually call and show you an actual... And I'll actually kind of show you now a video that I have made myself, kind of showing off the lights and the how you can use for the stereo and all that good stuff. So I hope you enjoy the video. So, if I can put the volume down there, as you can see, this laptop has got a lot of power under the hood on it, and I'm just enjoying GTA way too much at the moment to even just talk, if I can actually normally talk at the same time. I almost ran out of person. Yeah, it's just, if I mean, I love playing GTA, and I'm assuming this thing can run probably Crysis decently for those people who like Crysis. This is upgradable to 8 gigs of RAM. It does come with 4 gigs of this. 320 gig hard drive is pretty decent for, you know, what it can do. As you can see, it is a pretty good gaming computer, you know. On the road, you know, I can get 4 hours of GTA or something over here. So, you know, yeah, it's just awesome. As you can see, you can just go rolling around, jumping out of cars. So, you know, it's just awesome. You can go around pushing people like you just don't care. Get out of here, cop. No one likes you. I think you just swore at the cop. And as you can see, yeah, just it's so worth getting this thing of the price range this thing is, because originally it is about like $1,000 or $800. I don't know what the price is right now, but that's all I can remember. when I was buying, it was somewhere around those prices. But for what the horsepower this thing can put, it is so worth it, you know? So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll be putting out more product reviews. And, yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Please like this video. And if you can, just, if you have any comments or questions, put them down there. Also, please like the video if I have not said that for the millionth time already. And if you can do, subscribe if you'd like to see more of all this awesome action. I will be, though, promising you this, guys. A good system build with 16 gigs of Dominator Platinum memory, an MSI GTX 660, non-TI though, it's a 660, but not TI. That was awkward what I just saw. With the Core i7 3770K overclocked, cooled by a Corsair H80i, and I will show you gameplay of that off of this nice 1080p monitor. And that is if I don't fail and just drive into this pool. Oops, I just did. Well, what are you going to do? And the car is totally shocked. Done. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. And hopefully, not hopefully, there will be new videos coming out soon. Thank you very much.